Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So if this is your first time of watching any of my videos, make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you can get updates when I upload some of my exciting videos. And it's not only statistics that this video actually teaches. It actually teaches Microsoft Excel functions to functions that can actually help you in your place of work or during your research. So on this video, I'm going to be walking you through how to model your data to fit a Poisson distribution. So okay, so I have modeling data to fit the Poisson distribution. So I have as we know that the Poisson distribution is a discrete probability distribution function, and it is actually used when we tend to calculate the probabilities of rare events. Yes, so it's actually used during rare cases. In rare cases, where you have events happen in rare cases, events does not occur often. So that is where we use the Poisson distribution. So we have the lambda, which is the mean of the distribution. We have the x, the number of occurrences of a given event. So we are going to look at an example now, and we have a question here which says, 30 years ago Mr. Terry was acquitted and discharged for a crime he did not commit. Presently his case is under review, and below are the number of count charges levied against him. Fit the data to the Poisson distribution at 5% level of significance. So looking at this question, somebody has been freed 30 years ago, has been acquitted and discharged 30 years ago. Now presently you are bringing back the his case to say, oh, this man is actually guilty. So it's actually a rare event, and something that happens in real life. It rarely occurs, so it's a rare event. So we have the data set here. We have the court trials and the number of count charges. So the court trials, we assume it stands for hex, the x values, which is our number of occurrences, event occurrences. Then the number of count charges stands for the f, which is frequency. So now the first thing we're going to do is, before we fit the data to the model, we need to equate the sample mean of our the sample mean here. We need to equate it to the mean of the distribution we are working with. So, and the mean of the distribution we are working with is lambda, as we know that the mean and variance of a Poisson distribution is equal, which is lambda. So the next table here is a table I created trying to compute a sample mean. So we have the multiplication between x and f values, which gives us f of x here, and f times x, sorry. So here we equate the sample mean with the mean of the distribution. So we have 3, so the lambda equals to 3. Now going back, looking at this thing here, so we say therefore we have our distribution fit as, so we fit the value, the lambda, we set it as 3 and we put it in the distribution. So this is now the distribution. So going back to the Excel, we need to compute the probabilities of our event. So by computing the probabilities, we use the Poisson function. So we have the x value. The mean of our distribution is actually 3. Then we have the cumulative. We are actually picking the false option. If you watch my earlier video that I did on binomial distribution, I actually explained these two options. So please try and watch the video so that you can understand it very well. Okay, so let me put the mean as 3 here. All right. So, and the last one, okay, so here we have the probabilities of our event. Then so we go back to the Word document. Now we want to test the model fit. We're testing the model fit. Now we have two hypotheses here. We have the null hypothesis, which is saying the distribution of count charges fit a Poisson distribution, while the alternate hypothesis is saying that the distribution of count charges does not fit the Poisson distribution. Okay, so here we are using the chi-square distribution, goodness of fit. That is what we're using. If you remember that the chi-square distribution, there are some number of tests under the chi-square distribution. We have the test of homogeneity, we have the goodness of fit, we have the test of independence. So we are actually using the goodness of fit test, chi-square goodness of fit test here. So looking at the formula, we have the whole, which is the observed frequency, which we already have in our data here, which is our F. Then we need to compute for the expected frequency. So we'll go back to the Excel file. So we say expected frequency. Okay. So how do we compute for expected frequency? We multiply the sum of the frequency times the probability of each event. Okay, times 200. All right. Okay, so you have the orders here, order here. Then now we need to find the chi square calculated value using this formula. If you remember, so we are going to use this formula on Microsoft Excel. So let me just label it as chi square. Okay, so what do we do? So we have the observed frequency minus the expected frequency raised to power 2. Okay, then divided by the observed frequency. All right. Okay. So here we have the chi square calculated value, which is 3. Okay, so to get the chi square calculated value, we need to sum, because in the formula there is summation. So we need to find the sum of what is chi square value, or rather chi square point. Okay, so this is the chi square value. Let me just put chi square calculated. So we have 3.57. So you go back, let me just put it on the Word document here. 3.57. Okay, now looking at the degree of freedom. Now K is the categories of events we are looking at, or let's say number of events, which is actually 8. Then the M stands for the number of parameter in the distribution. So looking at this, looking at the distribution, the Poisson distribution, we really have one parameter, which is lambda. All right, so which stands for 1, then 1 is constant. So here we have 6. All right. Okay, so now how do we make decision? Because we need to make a decision whether this data fit the Poisson distribution or it does not. So we need to look for the p-value. Which is a probability value. So you're using the chi-square function, chi-square distribution. We're using this. The x stands for the chi-square value here, comma, the degree of freedom, which is 6. Okay. Now, what is our alpha? The alpha, which is our level of significance, is 0.05. So, looking at this value, the p-value is actually greater than the level of significance. It actually means we cannot reject the null hypothesis. So, let's go back to the word, and so we say, do not reject the null hypothesis. We did not reject the null hypothesis. Full stop. We conclude that we therefore conclude that the distribution of count charges fits the Poisson distribution. All right, so we've come to the end of the